What's up, guys? It's Dimz back for the attack, but you already know that, and let's just jump right into it, because this week is Kragg. Just a quick reminder, at max level, you have 8 spaces to fill with your runes. Mix and match to your heart's content, but remember, there is no reason not to fill up every single space. Now with that, let's get on to the runes. Rune A, forward strong, boost Kragg forward. Rune B, aerial attacks have increased knockback. Rune C, forward special has reduced startup. Rune D, while in forward special, you take no damage or knockback. Rune E, down special has increased knockback. Rune F, throwing rocks gives Kragg a speed boost. Rune G, rocks takes more damage to destroy. Rune H, forward special has faster movement. Rune I, down special creates more spikes. Rune J, you can spawn another rock even if one is already in existence. Rune K, up special has reduced startup and recovery. Rune L, more than one rock can be in existence at one time. Rune M, all of down special spikes appear all at once now. Rune N, all strong attacks have super armor. Rune O, up special can be used 3 times before touching the ground. Now, it's time to give my personal opinion on each rune. Keep in mind that I'm only factoring each rune effectiveness in Abyss Survival Mode, not Abyss Versus Mode, and I'm judging each rune as a sole entity. Also, remember to take my opinions with a grain of salt. For Rune A, having forward strong propel you forward is pretty cool. Like, you know, I can't really see anything bad about it. Rune B, with your aerials having more knockback, just means you're going to guarantee more kills by using aerial attacks, which is really good. Forward special having reduced startup makes it feel good to use, like it makes it feel better to use. So if you find yourself using a lot of forward special, you should definitely get this. Forward special letting you receive no knockback and no damage is great for a safety move, you know, it's like get off me, or if you just want to wrecking ball your way through enemies, like you will be 100% safe, it's a great thing. Down special having increased knockback just guarantees you earlier kills, so you know, also good rune. Being able to get a mobility boost by throwing your rock is actually great for movement around the field, which Kragg does suffer with a tiny bit. Having your rocks take more damage before being destroyed, remember this only applies to your enemies, it doesn't really do much unless you're just really afraid of your enemies hitting your rocks back at you, which you know, it's just a safety thing, I guess. Having forward special move faster means you're able to travel farther distances and all this great stuff. You know, if you use forward special, it's a great thing to have if you want it. Having down special create more spikes is a great for clear. Since, you know, it's 5 spikes and the battlefield is fairly small, you're going to be hitting a lot of people and you're going to be clearing a lot of things in front of you. Now, Rune J, I would say is a must have for Kragg. Being able to always pull a rock no matter what is actually really handy and great, no matter like whatever you're doing. Now be in mind, if you only can have one rock on the field at a time, the previous rock will explode upward, hitting anybody with the rock bits, but you will always be able to pull a rock with Rune J. Out of the list of all the great runes, Rune K is one of the lackluster runes. Having up special have reduced startup and recovery doesn't really have any noticeable difference. Like, it doesn't really matter, you don't have to buy this, don't buy this. Rune L, you're able to have more than one rock in play. Unlike Rune J, where you're always able to pull a rock, this time you will be able to have more rocks on the field, while Rune J, you're still able to only have one rock on the field at a time. Rune M might seem cool at first, having all the spikes appear at once, but in testing, there seems to be that there's a knockback reduction, or just a knockback inconsistency. Since all of them's coming up at once, and depending on how they hit the opponent, they might fly back less farther than if you didn't have them all come up at once. So it's a weird one. This is a weird one. Rune N, you can't go wrong with having super armor on your strong attacks if you love to just strong attack around and you don't want to get knocked out for it. And Rune O, being able to make three pillars before landing is a must-have for Kragg. It costs three spaces, but it is a must-have, especially for Kragg's role, which is coming up. Alright, with all the testing aside and all the information done, it's time to categorize Kragg. So, after all the testing, Kragg fits in the category as a supportive tank, mainly for his supporting role. Now, with Rune O and be able to use pillars, pillars are the main thing that's going to support your team because it keeps your teammates from dying. Whether you put a pillar up at one of the sides of the stages, and if you're one of your teammates get thrown into them, they can tech off of them, they will live longer, you can run off the battlefield and just save your teammates while they're trying to recover with a pillar and still be able to use another one, and you can negate the whole touch the floor round just by having a pillar up and your teammates just constantly jumping on it. It's mainly his pillar that keeps him alive. Being knocked away far away and be able to create three pillars, having three chances to come back, is one reason why Kragg won't die and why he would always support his team. He also has some great clear with his forward special and, you know, down special and all the other stuff, but mainly it's his pillars. That's why he works best as support. And because of his pillars keeping him and everyone else alive, it kind of makes him a tank. Not a tank in the way of like he's going to live to like 200%, but in a tank in a way saying he's not going to die early if they know what they're doing with their pillars. So, supportive tank it is. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you want to see more because I'm doing all the characters on the list. And, you know, that's it.